hello, ladies and freaks of the court. Welcome to the Queen Bazaar kitchen. That is the Queen D Bazaar's kitchen, and that is our house. So we just came back from, that was Hannah. She's the cheerleader in the background right now. We just came back from the farmer's market, and I have a lot of good advice. So I'm gonna start my, I kind of prepped everything, so I'm just gonna run through what I've done. We bought some spaghetti squash, and I already started the oven and set it to 400 degrees. I can't see who that is. Hello, Rain Red! So I set the kitchen to 400 degrees. Hannah cut the squash in half. It, at one point, looked like this with a top and a bottom, but she split those. I put some parchment paper on the pan, and now I'm just gonna basically season it and then throw it in the oven. So this is Himalayan salt, Himalayan pink salt, made with extra love always. I have some healing crystals around in the kitchen. I have crystals, I set them up everywhere. When I cook, I bring my energy into all of my foods and dishes. So, note for all of you new cookers out there, add your love and your energy into all that you do and eat and feed others. This is smoked salt. This is my first time using smoked salt. P.S. We bought this the other week at Farmer's Market. And then I'm just gonna put smoked sugar, but it's my first time using it as well, so. This is, yes, spaghetti squash. I put garlic salt, smoked sugar, sea salt, Himalayan sea salt, smoked salt, and now I'm going to grab a fork and stab that bitch. So you're gonna turn it over. Here, let's just show you what she looks like. Okay. So now you're going to just turn it over. And you're just gonna stab the bottom. Like one, two, three, four, right in the back. So one. Two. Ah, oh, these bitches are stronger than me. Three and four. Okay, these hoes. Okay, so I am, yes, going to grab that garlic salt and seasonings and put them back on here. I'm gonna add a little bit more garlic salt because that shit is good. Okay. Okay, and then remember to wash your hands. Like, you can't not wash your hands, ladies. So repeatedly wash your hands. I just use soap. You get it at the store. It ranges from like 10 cents to like five, depending on what kind of soap you want to get. Maybe even like 10 bucks, I think. Hello, hello, ladies. I am cooking in the kitchen right now. Okay, so I just prepped my spaghetti squash. I'll go ahead and show you that. So this is the spaghetti squash. Cut it in half. The oven is turned on to 400 degrees. I use some smoked salt or smoked sugar. Smoked salt. Garlic salt. And Himalayan salt. So those are my ingredients, and now I'm gonna pop this bitch in the oven. And where's my iPad? Cause I'm screaming in my casa right now, okay? We came back from the farmer's market and it's been so fun. I prepped everything. So now the oven is set to 400 degrees. I'm gonna put this in the oven for about 30 minutes. I'm gonna set the timer on the microwave, and then I'm gonna show you how I prep the mushrooms. And today I am baking the mushrooms, which I've never done before, so we'll see. Hopefully it turns out good. Feeding it extra loud. I like to bring my crystal, so I'll show you guys. I have my kitchen set up. I will bring you around. show you what I've done. So when you're cooking, it's not just about knowing how to cook, it's also about the energy that you're bringing into the foods that you're cooking for others and for yourself. So I do like to prep, and my preparation starts like this. I will go ahead and flip the camera. Let me switch. So I bring my plants over. This is an ivy plant. No, I'm not cooking that, but I bring my crystals over. I clean the whole kitchen. I put my seasonings in one corner. And then this is for the avocado. I basically just set up everything very nice. I have everything prepped. I have the mushrooms in there. Everything's all organized. So you're not basically going into cooking with a chaotic kitchen. You know where everything's at, you know what you're about to do, and you have the right energy inside your house. And you got the right tunes on. So, oh, I might have to change this because Instagram doesn't like when I use popular songs. I forgot. My bad, IG, don't delete me. Your boyfriend follows my boyfriend. Oh, that's dope. Hopefully your boyfriend buys my boyfriend's products, because then he will become an even better boyfriend to you and for you. Okay, now next up, I'm going to do some mushroom prepping. So a lot of people like to soak their mushrooms, and please do not soak your mushrooms. Treat them with care. I grab a paper towel, and I literally, like, how I clean my mushrooms is one by one, just wipe it off. It's like a lot of work, but still, it's worth it in the end, okay? I'm telling you guys. So just watch me do one by one. I have about 100 here. It's probably gonna take me a million hours. No. Grab your popcorn, grab your wine, send me over some wine. We ran out, I would be drinking it. How's your mother doing today? How are you doing today? How's your grandma? No, but really, how's your day been? How has your morning started? I woke up, honestly, you can't tell, but I woke up really like in a bunch of different energy motions, as in I had like sadness going through me. I had like what they say they consider depression. I had like all sorts of discombobulated freaking energies running through this beautiful home that I'm currently inside of. And I was grateful enough to have Arash's teachings to bring my mind back to reality and understand that I'm not the emotions, I am not my thoughts, I am not this body. I am far beyond that, and so are you. So if you're stuck in like a spin of like fucked up emotions and energies and thoughts, remember that you are not your thoughts, you are not your emotions, you are not those energies. You are far, far, far more beyond than those limitations you give yourself in life. Okay, I did forget to start the timer, so I'm gonna pop over there. Okay, so I don't know if your guys' microwave has this, but mine does, thank gosh. Whew. There's a timer. I'm gonna now set it to like still 30 minutes. So I'm gonna press 30, and then press that, and then it starts. And go. So do that. Prepping mushrooms and cooking spaghetti squash. Okay. So I really literally wipe each individual one. Give some random ones a kiss, because just giving your food extra love never hurt nobody. Okay, honestly, I don't kiss my food. That was like the only time I've ever done it. Don't do that, it's a little bit weird. You're like, hey, I kissed that mushroom, how does it taste? That mushroom was on my lips earlier. Thasher, P.S. love your jumpsuit. Thank you. Yes, it is Windsor. This whole outfit is a Windsor original. I love Windsor. It is one of, honestly, the only places I shop at now, because everywhere else is fucking wickety wickety whack. Even Express. I don't know if you guys have any boutiques or any knowledge of good clothing stores. I don't like dress normal, as you can say, like modern people. I like some weird, funky fashion, but I like it black. So if you have recommendations, please send them my way. I've looked on Pretty Little Thing and like, what is that famous one that Cardi B is on? Fashion Nova. Okay, I'm not like Fashion Nova style. Okay, so like if you have anything else besides like that like era of clothing, please send them my way because I can't find anything anymore.
I actually in LA found a store.
You did.
Fashion Nova, and I was like, okay, well like I've always been a little intimidated on the online site, and so I went in this store and just to be honest, I was like, oh, I have to get out of here right now.
There's a Fashion Nova. Hannah went into a Fashion Nova store, I don't know if you guys could hear her, in LA, and she walked in there and was like, okay, it's a little bit of a different era inside of here. It's just a different trend, you know?
Yeah.
I'm not a trender. We start trends. We help people freaking individuate themselves and make themselves an original freaking supreme superhero, superwoman character. So you go out in life and you're not an imitation of something else. You're a fucking great, you're the best imitation of your own super freaking villain, queendom character, whatever you want to create. I like creating a villain and a queen, P.S. I recommend that. Harley Quinn is famous for that one. Okay, I'm going to show you now what I'm doing. I, P.S., wiped all these mushrooms by hand, and now I'm just going to like wet this a little, but not too much, because you don't want to soak your mushrooms. Check out the new watch, P.S. Yeah. You know when people early try to show their rings, or like if you have your new nails done and you're like, hi, look at my hands. Oh no, I have mushrooms on my fingernails. Please do not screenshot that, people, all right? That was embarrassing. How are you guys? We are over here just living our motherfucking best life, trying to cook for a family of four right now. That family of four is me, Arash, Hannah, Electra. Is that four? That's four, right? Okay, you know what? I already passed math class. I don't need to freaking teach you guys math again. So, you heard the people that I called out. You do the math.
To be independent thinkers, ladies.
I miss home. Okay, so I literally, I'm just gonna show you guys. I like wipe off the skin, like the dirty skin. Just a recommendation. These mushrooms ain't loyal. You gotta clean these hoes up, okay? There's a lot of mushrooms popping around out there. There are a lot of dirty ones. You gotta clean those hoes up, make them a nice, cute little button, and then serve that hoe back up. Honestly, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about, so just, you know what, just go with it. You can laugh, I hope you're laughing. You can laugh at me. As long as you're laughing, just laugh. Because currently, I have no clue what the fuck I just said. All right, this is a lot of mushrooms. How fucking long have I been wiping mushrooms for? I'm not even joking, you guys. I've been wiping mushrooms for like ages. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 20. You guys don't even wanna know. It's more than 25 mushrooms that I've hand wiped, okay? But you know, live your best life. Treat your food kind, love your food. Gently wipe the dirt off. Don't soak that bitch up in the water. Okay, but on the real note, anyone have any nice wins that they want to share? Any great successes? Anyone have any babies? I don't know, that's always cool. Someone get a new job? Did someone make like $1 million? That's always fun. Share it. Share your wins, share your successes, and let others praise you for those things. Kobe Bryant died. Oh no, that's sad when people die. Well, that is, I don't know if that's a success.
Who said that?
That's broken hearts, broken hearts, broken hearts. Box of Knots.
Box of Knots.
What is your original, what is your real name? Here. She, if you guys go check out Box of Knots, I'm not even joking you, her Instagram is so fucking dope. She makes these handcrafted, I need to get some for inside of our house. Angela, she makes these handcrafted, I watch her lives, I watch her Instagram stories. She makes handcrafted little Box of Knots, literally. They're like these little hangy things, if you can like give a better description. They're really fucking dope. You put your plants inside of it. It makes your, not only your plants come to life, but it really brightens up your house and your room. So I recommend checking out Box of Knots Instagram. Angela handcrafts everything. And honestly, like, she makes these books. Like, just head on over there because there's a whole mixture of things that she does. Honestly, plant hangers, yes. They are plant hangers and I need some because I got some plants up in here. She has this cool life book that another Instagrammer, you know, it's so funny. I love making like friends on Instagram because I don't really know people like in person, but I know everybody through Instagram. So there's another Instagrammer named Lindsay. And she bought this book that Angela had made, and I was so intrigued by it. That's actually what got me to go follow Box of Knots. And then I saw the little plant hanging thingy, and I was like, oh my god, that's so cute. And like, the whole vibe is very, it's good energy. So if you want to bring good energy into your home, go check that IG out. If you want to learn how to wipe a mushroom one by one, stay here. Okay. Now I'm basically done. Okay, next up, we have all this, as you see, mushrooms. Hands literally cleaned by moi. And I'm also making avocado over here. Avocado is like my signature, like my favorite. Everyone always asks for it too. I actually have a friend that when I go over to her house, she asks me if I have brought the guac. And I'm like, no, but I brought me, so I'm here.
I can attest, I don't like avocado, but I like the way you make avocado.
Hannah says she does not like avocados, but she loves the way that I make avocados. So she is a testament of my guacamole. If you want to know the recipe, just, you know, message me. Come over to our house, try it out. Okay, I'm going to bring you guys closer to this. I'm not trying to show you a titty show, so here you go. I'm like, hold on, no cleavage here. Okay, so as you see, we got the avocado, right? And I literally skinned this whole thing. You don't have to do that. I actually don't recommend it. I just did it because it was cool and I could do it. So I cut it in half and I also cut it like a bunch of, I basically went like this and I went like this a bunch of times. So now I'm just going to finish it off and drop it inside of the bowl. NPS, my hands were cleaned. Hello, darling. I am here. I'm not just a freaking hand and teats and avocado and lemon. Okay. So, drop the avocado off in here. And I don't recommend doing this, literally, because I just peeled off the skin because it was fun. It was like, it was so ripe and I was so impressed by how incredibly delicious this avocado was and how ready it was that I was excited and skinned it like a fucking savage ass bitch. And with that being said, it's kind of sloppier how I'm making this avocado. This is not how it usually looks. Don't judge the mess, judge the taste, okay? So basically you give it a bunch of little chops, drop it off, chop her up inside. I did squeeze some lemon in there, and the funny thing is I do leave the avocado head inside. Okay, let's go over to where I do wash my hands so you guys can see that. I'm not a dirty little snatcheroo, okay? Dirty fingers being put inside of the sink, washing them. Soap. Pumped on the hand. Please use soap when you're like making food, like for real. Shit is needed. Get off all those germs. Okay. Okay, paper towel. All right. Hello, hello. Okay, so I have cut up the avocado, so now I'm gonna show you basically what I do. Since I showed you step by step prior, I cut off the top. You don't saw it like that. Please don't saw it like that. This knife just kind of got a little twisted. So you just cut off the top, boom, open it, see, okay. Then I also use the top because it's good. Like, why not use all the products, right? Okay, drop that little slut inside of there. Make her very green and crispy. Tell her that she's money if you want to. Okay, now I'm gonna cut it in half. Yes, I am an entertainer. Don't take anything that I say seriously. And respect the rules of the lands that you live in. That is something that I'm supposed to say before I go live. I'm missing a bunch of words, so I hope I get it right. Hopefully I don't get docked for this. Hopefully someone doesn't say Jessica told me to do this and I'm like, no bitch, I said respect the laws of the land that you live in. I didn't say do that if those rules aren't equipped with the same knowledge. Okay, so you cut that up, squeeze her in there because I really don't like getting super messy. But I will, like, I'll get dirty, but like, I don't like it, but I'll do it, but it's not needed, so don't. Okay, so Arash has his messenger still in town, and I am literally making avocado dip. Oh wait, where? That's why you set timers. I forgot I had spaghetti squash in the fucking oven, and thank God there's a timer, because if that timer was not on, honestly, I don't know how long it would have been in there for. And for you. So set those timers if you have short-term memory like moi, and remember that you're fucking baking other things while you're multitasking. But Arash has his men in town. Basically, these men came in from all over the world and paid him $25,000 to come learn from him for a whole weekend. And he's mentoring them this whole weekend. And it's really incredible because he's changing lives like beyond what anyone could ever give him credit for, which he doesn't ever, like, you know, it's not needed. When you're helping people, you don't need credit. You just want them to be better and you just want them to be okay again. And it's so beautiful seeing these people and hearing about their like changes and their transformations and like just how they're evolving in life. I'm like, damn, that's some other level shit. So I am prepping snacks for everybody because I just like doing that. And honestly, it's fun. And not often do you get to prep for a bunch of people, so when you can, go for it. Okay, now, oh, let me show you. I'm like showing my face, I'm like doing things down here. Okay, enough of my face. Okay, here you go. All right, so now I'm just kind of like mashing it in. I usually use tomatoes, but I forgot. Let's be real, I fucking forgot, okay? I squeezed so far a whole lemon. I've used 2 avocados, 1 whole lemon. I'm gonna sprinkle some Himalayan salt in here. I'm gonna do a dash of garlic salt. I would usually use raw garlic, fresh garlic. I don't know if there's a such thing as raw garlic. Maybe that's what fresh garlic is. But if you see your little like fork holes, I'm basically like using that to kind of like bring a little mash, and then boom, she's mashy. Oh, I'm so sorry, Totem. We have Totem here in the kitchen too.
Damn bitches, what the fuck? Good Instagram, how you doing? What's good? Y'all feeling fine? Learning how to make guac?
That is Totem.
And that is his dog voice. And yes, I talked to my fucking dog. And yes, he has a dog voice. And no, I wasn't the creator of that. Arash was. Okay, and I am a taster, so I have to Okay. No. You have to taste your food as a cook, as a chef, for others. You can't just give them a fucking surprise dish without knowing what it tastes like, okay? So, get inside that biatch. Okay. Honestly, I don't even know if anyone's gonna eat this. But this shit is fucking bomb. And if nobody likes it, they're just not okay. They're drunk, obviously. This shit's good. Anyone and their mom would say it's good. All right, my fucking guac is bomb. You will love this guacamole. You will eat the whole fucking thing and you will do it with a smile. You will not. Okay. Shit's bomb. I don't care. It's done. It's ready. It's not, actually. I still have, like... I only put one avocado in there. So, then you go, bam, twist that bitch to the side, drop her off. Okay. So, I will show you how I do this. Can you see that properly? Okay. Basically, a bunch of lines that way. You go slice that hoe up. You're like, what? I'm just kidding, okay? Treat her gently. She is filled with love. You are feeding love to others. Not crime. Okay. For real. You just like knife that hoe real quick. I'm sorry for calling these avocados hoes. If you're an avocadoist, I'm not. I love avocados. I'm not against avocados, okay? They are my friend, but like right now, I like consider them a hoe. My bad. It's just for jokes. I'm just trying to be cool on Instagram, okay? I'm just trying to make it in life. I'm trying to get big. Is this my fame video? Okay. So now that I've literally added two whole avocados, one lemon. Hello, Lily Machine. Anna. How, okay, what the front door is happening inside of here? Okay, so. There will be times where you find that there is a lemon seed in your guacamole. But don't you worry, ladies, because we have just the right thing for you. Fork it up. Search through your guacamole with your fork. If you find a seed, just pick it out. No one will ever know. Okay, no, but that's literally what I have to do sometimes. Like, before... Because I had made the mistake to give people my guac and there was a freaking lemon seed in it. I was so embarrassed. I'm like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Did you like choke on it? Did a lemon plant grow inside your stomach? My bad, are you okay? Did you have to go to the hospital? What happened? They tell me they're fine. They didn't choke, they just swallowed it. And I'm like, well, that's good. But you never want to feed somebody seeds. So that is how you make the enchanting avocado guacamole dip without fresh garlic and without tomatoes, just avocado, lemon, Himalayan salt, and garlic salt. This is for Arash's house for a snackage later. Oh my gosh, it tastes so bomb. So I'm going to put this in the fridge with a plastic wrap on top of it. This is how I'm serving it in a bloody bowl because I'm just like wicked like that. I freaking love that shit. So, go ahead and grab your plastic wrap. I do have a avocado seed inside of there. What the avocado seed does is it keeps your avocado fresh and the guacamole green. So you know when like you make guac or like you get avocado from a store or like you get guacamole from a store and it turns brown? The reason for that is due to the fact that the main seed that it grew from isn't inside of it. that still keeps the nutrients in it and it keeps everything fresh. So if you have a avocado seed, don't throw it away. Add it inside the bowl with your avocado and it'll keep everything inside of the green. So this is now going in the fridge. We're gonna go check on the spaghetti squash. Let's see how she's doing. Turn this over. Let's turn the oven light on. What does she look like, Totem? What does it look like? What do you think? Is it ready? Damn nigga, I'm fucking hungry. That's all I know. Okay, so that's not ready yet, but let's just give her a look. Oh yeah. Okay. Good energy is still around. All right, ladies. Well, I have showed you how to prep the mushroom, the button mushrooms. I showed you how I make my spaghetti squash. I showed you my famous avocado, just missing the... Well, basically, I didn't show you my famous avocado. I showed you how to make a version of my guacamole that's just missing tomatoes and garlic. And next up, I'm just gonna throw these in the oven. I have 8 more minutes left on the spaghetti squash. I'm gonna put these mushrooms in there for about 20 minutes. And until next time, I will show you guys what everything looks like after. But like Arashi Bazaar always says, be the best and fuck the rest. Remember, it is all in a state of mind. And if you are stuck in your emotions today, if you are stuck in your mind today, if you're stuck in these things and conditions of life, remember, you are not your thoughts, you are not your emotion, and you are not the things that are happening around you. You are far beyond that, and you are powerful enough to make the day however you want it to be and however you want it to come out and be gifted as. So you're wrapping up the present of your life and you're putting the bow on that bitch. Don't think you don't have the pen. Remember, you are in charge. Like Arashi Bazaar always says, it's all in a state of mind. Mwah.